my plea. Though my eyes cry, through my tears, I see the world's trend. We done crept up in some real sin. We so spent now to be swept up in a whirlwind. And it seems like it won't stop till the world ends. How much more, Lord, will you endure until then? Since Adam, this pattern has plagued us. We followed our passions and look where it led us. You watched as Adam's first offspring offed his brother cause he was jealous of his offering. And as the years passed, we just kept going. The floods came as your tears flashed, mixed with the steam from your fierce wrath, from your broken heart. Only those in the ark with Noah passed, cause only Noah found favor, even though Noah couldn't hold it down later. Neither could Abraham, neither could any of the prophets or priests or kings that you raised up stand. So with all these men, if you were grieved then what keeps you from being grieved again?
We know it's not nothing, we know it must be something that keeps you from being so great again. There were more than one flood if it wasn't for your sons, but to keep you from being great again. We know it's not nothing, we know it must be something that keeps you from being so great again. There were more than one flood if it wasn't for your sons, but to keep you from being great again.
Fast forward from the past toward the present, pass the torch, light the path for us heaven. More than ever, cause it's darker than it's ever been. We should be on the outside of the ark screaming,
let us in.
Check how we be with all our technology, with more ways to sin than any one man can possibly. And yet we invent more, like slaves indenture, like sin vents through our pores. Evil as far as we can see. Now we know drama like TNT. We found Pandora's box, smashed the locks. Now look what's popping up at us, even on laptops. Watch, they push sin in the cinema, loving it, even voted into our government. Quick to shed the blood of the innocent, or know about it and won't do a thing to put an end to it. The way we see is distorted, babies having babies, either we applaud it or abort it. How can we afford to be so evil when you flooded Earth once? What do we think keeps you from being breathed again?
We know it's not nothing, we know it must be something that keeps you from being so great again. There were more than one flood if it wasn't for your sons, but to keep you from being great again.
Lord, I know our sin is sky high, and I know you don't turn a blind eye. You see every instance, all at an instant, and you don't scoff at sin's stench. So, you know we're wondering, where's all the rain and thundering? Or did we get away with our dirt? Did the darkness cover us? Are our sins hid? Won't your eyelids uncover us? But it's not that you're passive, it's just that your grace is as active as your wrath should be. So we casually sin, so we're sentenced to sin to where there'll be gnashing of teeth. After Noah's flood, there was two judgments left, the cross and the one at the end, that's death. And it's not sleep forever, it's beef with God and feeling the heat forever. The rest of this life without God, that's hellish. The afterlife without God, that's what hell is. And we don't want that, so before you come back and all man gets beat down like drum tracks, before Messiah comes, before your eyes are tired of our lives and the fire comes, help us to see your son and our need for him, cause his blood is the rich flood that keeps you from being breathed again.
We know it's not nothing, we know it must be something that keeps you from being so great again.